Listening Library presents Save the Koalas by Anita Sanchez and Chelsea Clinton. Read for you by Shiromi Arserio. With a letter written and read by Chelsea Clinton. 1. Life in the Poison Forest. Have you ever hugged a koala bear? You might have. A lot of the stuffed teddy bears you see on toy store shelves are designed to look like cute, fuzzy koalas. But in real life, there's no such thing as a koala bear. The small mammals known as koalas are often called bears because they look like little bear cubs, with their short, round ears, pudgy bodies, and stubby noses. But koalas aren't related to bears at all. They're a special kind of animal called a marsupial, which means that they carry their babies in a pouch on their stomachs. These funny, furry animals are some of the most amazing creatures that live on the huge island continent of Australia. The Boy Who Fell from the Tree. Since Australia is not connected by land to any other continents, the animals there evolved to be very different from the creatures found everywhere else in the world. It has fascinating creatures like kangaroos, wombats, duck-billed platypuses, and koalas. Koalas have lived in Australia for a long, long time. People searching in the rocks of Australia have found fossils of koala-like animals that might be more than 20 million years old. That means koalas were living in Australia long, long before people arrived. Humans probably came to Australia about 50,000 years ago. No one knows exactly where these adventurous people came from, but they must have crossed the wide, dangerous seas in boats. And once they did, they found a land filled with forests, with millions of koalas living high in the treetops. These first people to arrive on the mainland, known as Aboriginal peoples, were the only humans who lived in Australia for tens of thousands of years. Their stories about how the earth was created and shaped are called the Dreamings, and they describe how the rocks, plants, animals, and everything else fit together. Over the centuries, they have told many tales about the wise-eyed creatures that clamber in the branches over their heads. Thousands of years ago, they gave these animals the name koala, which means no water. Those long-ago storytellers had observed a very unusual thing about koalas. They almost never drink. According to one legend, there was once a boy who lived in a dry land. His enemies refused to share their water and wouldn't let him drink from the ponds or streams. But one day he had an idea. He hung buckets of water high in the branches of trees so that he would always have enough to drink. Sadly, he fell from the treetops, but his body was magically healed and turned into a koala. The water he had hidden in the trees flowed into the leaves. Koalas need water to survive, of course, as all living things do. But unlike most other land mammals, they can get the water they need from the moisture in the plants they eat. They only climb down from their treetops to search for water during a heat wave, or if they can't find enough juicy leaves. The Trees of Life. Trees are koalas' life-giving habitat. Trees provide them with food, water, a place to sleep, and a home to shelter their babies. But koalas won't feed on just any kind of tree. Koalas are very, very picky about what kinds of leaves they eat. Koalas eat almost nothing but the leaves of eucalyptus trees, which are evergreens with long, pointed leaves that are glossy green. Evergreens are plants that stay green all year long. These trees have oily sap that is as sticky as gum, and Australians often call them gum trees. If you've ever sung Kookaburra Sits in the Old Gum Tree, you were singing about the koala's favorite tree. But even once they find gum trees, koalas are still pretty picky. There are more than 700 species of eucalyptus and the fussy koalas will eat leaves from only about a dozen of those. Koalas have to find just the right kind of tree before they climb up and start snacking. Those cute black noses have a keen sense of smell, and a koala can tell if a tree is the right kind just by sniffing it. Eucalyptus forests make up about 3/4 of Australia's total forest land. They thrive in the hot, dry climate and can grow even in soil that doesn't have a lot of nutrients in it. And these shaggy, scraggly-looking trees have a wonderful secret. If you rub one of the leathery leaves, it gives off a strong scent that's hard to describe, sort of minty fresh and clean, but also spicy. You might have smelled it when you had a cold, as it's found in many different kinds of cough drops and cold remedies. If you want to know what a gum tree smells like, sniff a jar of Vicks Vapor Rub. Aboriginal peoples honour the eucalyptus as a special tree with healing powers, and modern medical research has shown that they're right. Eucalyptus does help to kill germs and to clear a stuffy nose or chest. For koalas, the best thing about feeding on eucalyptus leaves is that few other kinds of animals eat them. Wombats, a type of Australian mammal that looks a bit like a short-legged, fat koala, will also eat eucalyptus leaves. But wombats live on the ground, not high in trees. Even most insects don't eat gum tree leaves. The strong scent is the tree's way of discouraging bugs from nibbling the leaves. So koalas have little competition at mealtimes. Here's another reason that koalas don't have much competition for their meals. Eucalyptus leaves contain a powerful poison. The oily juice found in the leaves contains several powerful chemicals that are harmful to most mammals. Just 1 teaspoon of pure eucalyptus oil could kill a person. When humans use it as a medicine, only tiny amounts are given. This powerful toxin is the way the tree protects itself. If eucalyptus leaves were sweet and delicious, they'd soon be gobbled up by many different creatures. But how can koalas eagerly munch on leaves that would make another mammal drop dead? The answer lies inside the koala's furry tummy. All mammals, including people, have a body part called a liver that acts like a filter, straining harmful substances from the blood. But koalas have what some scientists call a super liver that is especially good at removing the eucalyptus toxins as they pass through the animal's body. Koalas can eat the leaves without so much as a stomach ache. The toxins are strained out of the bloodstream and leave the koala's body in its urine. Life in the slow lane. But wait, there's another reason that most other animals don't try to eat eucalyptus leaves. Not only are they toxic, they're also low in nutrition. Most foods that wild animals seek out are filled with nutrients to give them energy and help them grow strong. People need nutritious food too. When you eat a leaf of spinach, for example, it gives you protein, iron, calcium, vitamins, and lots of other things your body needs. But eucalyptus leaves are very low in nutrients. And like most leaves, they're also low calorie, which means they don't provide much energy. Once again, the solution lies inside the incredible koala stomach. Koalas have a really long digestive system, much longer than that of other animals their size. It's full of twists and turns, where the tough eucalyptus leaves are slowly broken down by stomach acids so that every ounce of nutrition can be used by the animal. But because they eat such a low-calorie food, koalas have little energy to spare. Almost everything koalas do is slow. They'll spend hours in the same tree, choosing and munching leaves. Then they'll slowly clamber down from the tree, bottom first. When they find a promising new tree, they climb up and start to eat again. Koalas eat almost every minute that they're awake, but that's not for long. As soon as koalas are full, they fall asleep. Sometimes they even doze off while chewing. Those long, curved claws help the koala cling tight to branches, even in their sleep. And koalas sleep a lot. often about 20 hours a day. They crouch in the branches, dozing all day and most of the night. They sometimes poop in their sleep. As soon as they wake up, it's back to eating. They can chew their way through about a pound of leaves in a day. Then it's time to nap again.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.